close till I get up. Time is barely on our side. I don't wanna waste what's left. Hello guys, what's up? Thank you so much for watching Circuits Bazaar. So today we are going to show the demo of a project which we can use in our bikes. The name of this project is Smart Helmet. So in this helmet, whenever you will put this helmet, only then your bike will start, and your bike won't start if you don't put that helmet on your head. So this project is basically for the safety purpose. So now we are going to show the demonstration of this project. If you want to see the live demo of this project after installation in the bike, then you can see the video which is given in the description given below. But for this project, I'm going to show you how it's working. So in this project we are using two modules. This module is will be fitted on the bike, right? This is for the bike section, and this module will go on the helmet. This is for the helmet representation. Okay, so one by one I am going to discuss all the things in these two projects. So if I talk about this one, so in this project this is the button. This button will be installed in the top of the helmet, so whenever you will put that helmet on your head, so this button will get pressed automatically. And this is the alcohol sensor which will go in the front of the helmet where your breath is going, right? So if you have consumed alcohol, so those alcohol fumes will strike to this sensor, which is alcohol sensor. So this alcohol sensor will then give data to the module. This module is basically RF transmitter and a decoder module, and this is 7805 voltage regulator which is converting 9 volt which is coming from the battery into 5 volt, because your transmitter module and the encoder IC, which is ST12E, this IC is also working on 5 volt. That's why you have used 7805 voltage regulator. And this is this red LED is the LED which will show you whether power is given or not. And one thing you must be careful, you have to provide proper power supply. If you will provide opposite power supply, then the circuit will burn out. So plus and R, plus means positive, and that is red wire. This is the battery. In this battery there are two wire, plus means red and black means minus. So B minus means black, so you will apply like this way, okay? Minus in this direction, plus in this direction. LED is glowing, so you have provided power supply. And this is the sensor. This sensor will sense the alcohol, and this button will be fitted in the helmet. So this is the demo version. That's why I have put everything on a wooden board, so that you can clearly notice what's going on in the project. So this is the helmet module. Now if I talk about this module, this is called bike module. This module will be fitted on the bike, because we don't have bike over here, so that's why I have used this DC motor. This DC motor will keep on running if the helmet is proper on the head, and the person is not drunken. If the person is drunken, then in that case this motor won't start. If the person take out the helmet of their head, even then the motor will stop. This is the buzzer which will provide you the indications, like whether the person is not having helmet on his head, or alcohol is drunken or not, right? So this buzzer will provide the status. And this is the high power 10mm red LED which will glow along the buzzer, right? This is the LCD which will show you in the real time what's going on in the project. For example, if the motor is not working, it means bike is not working, then the message will be on the LCD, and the LCD will show you the status, what's problem is going on. Like if you don't have a helmet on your head, then this message will be shown on the LCD. And how these two modules are communicating with each other? They are communicating with RF transmitter and receiver. As I already told you, this is RF transmitter and this is RF receiver. This RF receiver will get data from the helmet and will provide that data to the microcontroller through this decoder IC, which is ST12D. And this is L293D IC. This L293D IC will generate data for the motor, because you can't drive this high current motor directly using microcontroller. You have to use motor driver IC, which is L293D, to drive this motor. And we have used this green color resistor so that you can limit the current, because the motor is consuming very high amount of current, so that current is limited by this resistor. And the microcontroller which we are going to use in our project is ATmega328, which is Arduino. You can say we have program the program in the Arduino. You can find the program and all these type of things in the description given below. And this is the power supply. This power supply have a rectifier, because if you don't have adapter, even then you can drive this project using transformer, because we have used a rectifier, which is bridgeway rectifier. As you know that the output of bridgeway rectifier is not pure DC, it have ripples as well as fluctuation. So for that thing you have used pi filter, two capacitor. These two capacitor will bypass the fluctuations coming from the bridgeway rectifier and make it pure DC. Then that 12 volt DC will be converted into 5 volt DC using this 7805 voltage regulator, which will convert 12 volt DC into 5 volt DC. Then this is the power LED which will show you that you have applied power to the project. You don't have to care about these connectors, because I have internally connected. The main power you have to provide adapter to this connector, right? adapter. And if I talk about adapter, then this is the adapter. And if you will see the grooves in the adapter, you can't apply it in opposite direction, and don't try to insert the adapter from the opposite direction. Plus means red will come in the upper direction, plus red, minus black. So black will go in this direction and plus will come in the front direction, like this. Okay, so now I am going to show you the live demo of the project. So okay, so first of all, you have to provide power supply to the project helmet section. So this is the power supply to the helmet section, plus in the upper direction, means plus means red. Okay, okay, plus is given. Now provide power supply to this project through adapter. So this is the adapter which we are going to use. This is 1 ampere adapter for this project. Plus will come, plus means red will come in the upper direction and black means in the lower direction. Now I am going to provide power supply. So initially motor will run, as you know. Now one thing you have to remember in this project, first you have to provide power supply to the helmet, because this is a demo mode. So you first provide power supply to the helmet, then you will provide power supply to the this version, which is for the bike representation, right? So now I am going to provide power supply by watching carefully the polarity of the project. Red LED glow means power is provided properly. Now you will provide power to this project through the adapter, right? And this button is not pressed. If this button is pressed, it means you have put down the helmet on your head. If this button is not pressed, it means you haven't put the helmet on your head, right? So initially I am not using this button, so that you can see that what's going on in the project. So I provide the power supply. So please put the helmet. This is the message on the LCD. This message means helmet is not put down on your head. So there is no physical connection between this module and this module. This is represented as a helmet and this is represented as a bike. So if I press this button, then buzzer is off and motor is running. It means bike is running, because this is pressed and this will be in the helmet. This will automatically be pressed whenever you will put helmet on your head. And ignition on. Ignition on is the message on the LCD, because ignition is on. That's why this motor is working right now. And if you want to see whether your RF receiver and RF transmitter is in the communication of each other or not, then you can easily see this thing by watching these LEDs. These all the LEDs are glowing, and this is particularly is the communication LED. If there will be no power, then these LEDs will be off. It means they are not synchronized with each other in the communication. So right now, if I remove the this battery, then you can see that this LED is off. Okay, and whenever I will provide power supply, then this LED will be on. It means the helmet is in the communication of your bike. Now you can see that this LED is on. This LED is off. Whenever you remove the power, means there is no communication between the helmet and the bike. Whenever you will put, then it means they are in communication with each other. So as soon as I will remove my hand, means helmet is taken out. So the buzzer is beeping and the motor will stop after some time. Now no helmet is the message on the LCD, because this button is open. Why this button is open? Because there is no helmet on your head. So that's why, right? If I will press this button, then the motor will start running. Like ignition on, message on the LCD. If I will leave the button, then again after giving beep and red indications, then motor will stop. It means there is no power. Now this is the function of helmet button. Now I am gonna show you the function of this alcohol sensor. So for that thing I need alcohol, so I am coming with alcohol just in a few seconds. So this is the alcohol. This alcohol we are going to use in the sensor. Okay, right now no helmet. Okay, so first of all provide the proper condition so that the motor will start running. Now ignition is on, motor is running. So this is the alcohol. So I will take alcohol fumes near to this sensor, right? Now I'm going to show you the alcohol working. Now you can see alcohol detected. So after some time motor will stop. Why? Because the system has sensed the alcohol. So in this way you can sense the alcohol. So this yellow LED is glowing. This yellow LED is representing that system has sensed the alcohol. If there will be no alcohol, because still there are alcohol fumes in the sensor, then after some time motor will be on, like ignition on, because there is no alcohol. As soon as I will take alcohol again, and you have to keep this button pressed so that you can properly sense the working of this alcohol sensor, right? Now again I am going to take alcohol near to the sensor. Now you can see alcohol detected, that's why buzzer is beeping, and after some time motor will stop. Why? Because alcohol is detected. And if you can see that there is a yellow LED, this yellow LED is representing that sensor has sensed the alcohol, okay? If you will take alcohol away from this sensor, then after some time this LED will be off and motor will be on because there is no alcohol fumes in the helmet. You can clearly see this thing, right? Ignition on, why? Because there is no alcohol. So this is the simple working of this project. If you have any doubt, then you can let me know in the comment box. Thank you very much for watching this project.